Top Gun Maverick was originally supposed to come out this Friday, so I thought I'd go back and review the original Top Gun film. This film is one of the best films from the 1980s. It has a great cast, the music is awesome, and there are some great aerial fight scenes in this film. And this is a movie I highly enjoy. Directed by the late Tony Scott, Top Gun is a 1986 film that stars Tom Cruise, Kelly McGillis, Val Kilmer, Anthony Edwards, and Tom Skerritt. And it's about Tom Cruise, he plays Pete Mitchell, aka Maverick, a young Navy aviator who aspires to be one of the best airmen in history. And from there, the film is very interesting. It's about a tale of machismo and tough guy, macho man, trying to prove they worth and dog fighting. And I like this film a lot. In fact, when I recently rewatched this film, it was like a refresher because before I rewatched the film, I ain't seen this film in a long time. And I enjoy a lot of things about it, especially the acting from Tom Cruise and Kelly McGillis. I think they're some of the highlights of the film. The music is great in this movie. And you have some very interesting aerial fights. Now, is this a awesome film? Like, is it one of the best? No, I won't go that far. But I will say everyone did a good job in this film. And I especially like a lot of things about this movie, such as the action sequences, the fast aerial stunts. It all ties together real nicely. Now, I would have liked if we learned more about Maverick, especially since Tom Cruise does such a good job in this film. In fact, this is one of his earlier films, if I remember correctly. This film came out even before he did the Mission Impossible movie that came out back in the 1990s. Now, what's interesting, this film also won an Academy Award for the song Take My Breath Away by Berlin. And I found that real interesting. Seriously, if you've never seen this film, I suggest you watch it because it's certainly worth your time.
Now, I'm going to be honest with you guys. I really did try to follow this movie, and I did. But there's several spots in the film where it kind of slows down. We get to learn the characters. And it's not much of an action film per se. It's more like a macho, tough guy movie. You have Iceman, played by Val Kilmer. He's like the rival of Maverick. You have Goose, played by Anthony Edwards. He's like the best friend. He dies like midway through the film, and that's like caused some emotional effect on Maverick. And I thought that was real interesting. Sometimes certain character deaths in films can affect our main characters, and it tells a better story because of it. Now, while I'd like to see more of this film in terms of character depth, of course, we get some backstory on Maverick, but really not a lot. It's more or less about guys trying to prove they're the best and what they love to do, that's being and basically aerial combat. Now, the ending is great, but what I would like to see from this film is the things I just mentioned. But this is not a bad film. It's just, after all these years, it is still remembered as one of the significant films from the mid-1980s.
I'm giving this film an 8 out of 10. Well, I enjoy some things about this movie, such as the story and action sequences. It's not enough character depth, especially for Charlotte Blackwood, aka Charlie, the love interest of Maverick. I mean, we don't know much about her. And I would like to see some more action sequences in this film. But I think this film is highly worth rewatching even today, especially with the lack of new movies that are out. Well, you know what I mean, the lack of movies in theaters as of this recording. But nonetheless, though, I do like this film. I would just leave it at that. And that's my review of Top Gun. Alright, leave your comments down below in the section and let me know what you think about this film. Do you love it, hate it, or in the middle? And also, what are your thoughts on Top Gun Maverick that comes out this December? You know, we really didn't need a sequel to this film for two reasons. Number one, it's over 2 decades old. Number two, what kind of story will you tell? I really believe that some movies don't need sequels. This is one of those movies. So I don't really care for a sequel, but the original Top Gun still holds up today. Okay, this is Slim Guy 172 saying, peace out.